Hello guys, we are back with our next tutorial. In this tutorial, let us go through the disk scheduling algorithms. So basically, we are having six different types of disk scheduling algorithms. So basically, these disk scheduling algorithms help us to reduce the seek time. So I hope everyone remembers what is seek time. So seek time is nothing but the minimum time taken for your read-write head to adjust to your particular track. Fine? Okay. So to reduce the seek time, we'll be using this scheduling algorithms, guys. Disk scheduling algorithms. So basically, these are totally six, guys. FCFS, SSTF, scan, C-scan, look, C-look. So we'll be discussing one after the other. We'll be going through one problem, guys, so that it will be clear for you. Okay. So the given problem is in this way. Explain the disk scheduling algorithm for the given examples. Okay. They gave the six names. So we'll be discussing in each video. We'll be discussing one after the other. So he gave the total number of cylinders is 200. Okay. So initially he told that the read write head is at 53 and previously it visited 37. So initially it was at 37. It reached 53 and now we started our program or our process. So the IO requests are given below. Those are nothing but these are the requests. So FCFS. So the first thing is FCFS. So from the name we can say first come first serve. So whatever the first thing comes, we'll be serving it. We'll not be checking any conditions that which is smaller or which is greater. Is there any priority or anything like that? We'll be directly coming in order. So let us draw it first. So remember, guys, while drawing this, you should start from 0 to 199. So we need to have exactly 200 disks. Don't write like this 200. It should be 199. Fine? Okay. So just mark some random marks, kings. So let us assume this has 50, this has 100, and this has 150. Fine, just to do your approximations, guys. Okay, so initially it was at 37, right? Okay, 37 will be somewhere here. So mark 37, just draw a small line and place a dot. Okay, after 37, it moved to 53. So here, let us assume it is 53. Okay, so 53, dot a point. And just draw a cross line that direction with direction. So after 53 it went to 98. It is first come first serve, so it should go in that order only. So 98, let us assume it is here. So rotate it, just mark a point approximately and just draw a line and place arrow. Further moving on, it is 129. So let us assume it is here, 129. So 129, mark a point, place it, arrow. After that, it came to 57. So it came back. 57 means it is somewhere here. So draw an arrow. 57. So next to 122, it's again going back. 122. So it is somewhere here. Okay. So after 122, again 14. So it is coming completely back. 14. So this will be your 14. So after 14, it is 12. So it is before it. So 12. So after 12 it is 25, it should stop here, 25, let us assume, 25, 12, okay. After 25 it went to 47, so assume this is 47, okay. So we are having 47. So this is your diagram, guys. By using this you will be finding the number of cylinders and minimum cylinders and you will be calculating the seek time, okay. Okay, so basically let us first go through the calculation of seek time, guys. So basically seek time, to calculate seek time you'll be doing a small trick. So just follow what I'm saying, follow my words, guys, and observe what I'm writing. So basically from where you started, guys, just write that order here. Okay, I'll be just writing it right below here. Okay, so let me rotate my phone so that you can clearly see it. Okay, so where did we start? We started at 37. So after 37 we went to 53. So write the exact order from the question. It will be really easy because it is the first thing, right? So first come first serve, right? So that's the reason why it will be really easy. 37 after 98, same, write the question. 29 after 29, 57, 122, 14, 25, 47. So this is the exact order in which you traveled here. So basically you need to write this list from the traveling path. So 37 to 40, 53, 53 to 98, 98 to 129, 129 to 57, 57 to 122, 122 to 14, 14 to 12, 12 to 25, 25 to 47. So that's what I have just written here. So now you will be calculating the individual difference between these two, difference between these two, difference between these two, difference between these two, difference between this 25 or 24. Sorry, it is 14. Oh, sorry, 122. 122 minus 14. 14, 25. 25, 47. So in this way, you'll be calculating the values, guys. So you, as we'll be permitting with Calci, so we can directly do it in Calci really easily and fastly. So you'll be using Calci for doing this, guys. So after doing in Calci, you'll be getting values like this. 16, 4. So even if you get negative values in this, make mod. It is nothing but make all values to be positive. So we got 374. Here 374 will be your seek time. So what are the advantages, guys? So we are just executing whatever coming is first. So just by observing this, you say me, guys. Here we are traveling this way, this way, this way, this way. You're just going like a snake in all the directions again and again. So here we are just wasting our time moving here and there, right? So basically the advantages is will be every request will get a chance, right? So we gave in exact order, so every request is getting a chance, so we are giving a fair gameplay for all the things and we are not postponing anything. So that will be the advantages. So the disadvantages will be we are not getting any optimized seek time. See here how much seek time we are getting, 374, guys. I think if we do in normal way, we'll be getting our 150, around 160. Here we are getting 350, almost it's double. So may not provide the best service. It is not best, it is best, guys. Sorry for that. It will provide best service. So I hope everyone got a small idea on this. So in the next tutorial, we'll be going through the shortest seek time first. SSTF, shortest seek time first. So let us meet in the next tutorial. Thank you. Thanks for watching.